Hello everyone, welcome back now. ESL One Manila SEA qualifiers. Game 2 now between Tearing versus WG.Unity. I'm Zembrella, join my mod packs. And that first game turned into be a pretty interesting one.
Yeah, it wasn't the blowout that it was seeming to be, at least in the early phases of the game. So we are now all set for a game number 2. And that Invoker, it is still the pool. And wow, a really early brood ban. That is kind of funny.
Interesting.
Warriors Gaming. I think this is the same kind of an idea where you want to ban out a not, like, it's a hero that you want to ban later anyway, but they're doing it now because they have the first pick and they're trying to open up like a fourth good hero, like kind of OP status for that opening four.
Still, Invoker could be there for Nana if he wants to pick it up.
I imagine that's definitely gonna be the pick, honestly. Like, it's good against Batrider. It's a combo so nicely with the Nature's Prophet, and I'm surprised they just haven't grabbed it already.
Yeah, I feel like Tearing, this must be like their comfort pick or something with the Batrider, because they pick up the Venge and the Batrider straight away.
Yeah, I just want to make sure that, obviously, you know, the whole counter thing, so it's a pretty solid opener. Doesn't really give away anything. The Batrider could theoretically be mid, more than likely going to be the offlane, though.
Yeah, I mean, ever since, like, Abaddon and Oracle are in the pool now, that's two other counters that are pretty good to Batrider. Oh, and Legion as well.
Yeah.
But I'd be interested to see a Legion. I don't think Warriors Gaming will pick it up because it would have to be played in the carry role. But I do enjoy a good Abaddon.
Yeah, I'm a fan. I like the four role of Ed. It's a good hero. What are we at now? Drought Bandit, pretty classic against Nature's Prophet Invoker. Don't want to deal with that. Gonna get rid of some of the greed. And now this was where the Doom could theoretically come out, as it was something that Tearing have shown a penchant for. You know, they like whipping that thing out, I would say. Yeah. So I'd be too shocked.
Definitely looking like some sort of push lineup from Warriors Gaming, or has the potential to become one anyway.
Oh, geez, I'm getting my teams mixed up here. It was Warriors with the Doom. Okay, all right, we're good.
It was Tearing, right?
The push could certainly come out. The Beastmaster is still there if you want to go for that, like, kind of crazy four-roll Beastmaster. I really dig that, honestly. Well, there's the Oracle ban and the immediate Spectre pick for themselves this time. So you can see how hard it was. Despite being shut down relatively early, the Spectre, just once that Haunt came online, still would make a lot happen around the map, so pretty pleased to see Tearing grabbing that up for themselves. Won't have the combo of, like, Nature's Prophet, Invoker, and Spectre. A lot of global presence.
And the Batrider and the Spectre combo pretty well together as well.
Yeah, they do. Great combo. If you're, like, smoked up as a team and you run into somebody, like, even if Spectre's not there, you guys are smoked up with your Batrider, the other four heroes, you know. The second the smoke breaks, you pop the Haunt, and it allows him to prioritize whoever he wants for that Blink Lasso. And, well, it does look like it just might be the mid Batrider, just something we haven't seen in a while.
Unless you're watching Alliance.
Yeah, pretty much. That's like Alliance. Old Team Aracon used to run a lot with Monkeys Forever. That was kind of his big hero. But other than that, not too many other squads willing to pull that one out. At least not now. During the start of this patch, it was a lot more popular. But lately, it's basically just been the offlane or even a couple, like, basically jungling. I saw an Iron Talon first bat yesterday, which was pretty strange. It worked out surprisingly well, though. I was impressed.
I mean, Lion's actually okay against Spectre in a way, just because of his two instant illusion killer spells.
Yeah.
I guess Warriors Gaming might now look towards something like the Juggernaut to deal. We saw last game how well Juggernaut can deal with the Darkseer. I mean, Darkseer still got farm, but at least he didn't get hindered.
Yeah, I wonder if they're going to go for another four roll here for Tearing, kind of the same idea, like, be it that Night Stalker or Spirit Breaker or Tusk or something like that, something they can get nice and aggressive and in your face with a Darkseer, because those are the kind of heroes that I think really, like, push this hero, you know, into that topper tier. They don't really have anything that they vacuum into yet either, so might be like a... there's no one that really does both of those things, so if they wanted to go back for, like, a Disruptor or something to make the Spectre feel a little bit safer, that would be okay as well. Just something that still combos up nicely with the Vacuum. Or even an Earthshaker would be pretty cool, too. Good against the Nature's Prophet. helpful against the Lion as well, just because he like gets bursted down so fast by the Echo Slam if he happens to be nearby.
Invoke also with the Forge Spirits, extra leeches. Yeah. Actually, I really like that idea. But Chen, it becomes better now.
I don't have a choice.
Man, I still like the Nyx. I mean, look at all these intelligence heroes. Like,
it's true. It's like, it would be greedy in a lot of ways, but Nyx or even a Bounty, just because that's so sad. I was going to say, like, the Bounty, because the early end is, right?
There's the Doom, though.
Okay. This is pretty good. We've seen a lot of Doom plus, like, Faceless Voids in the offlane, so I think this could work out if they send the Doom down with the Darkseer, right? He can kind of pull over, devour a creep, take an Iron Shell, maybe get himself a net.
Yeah, good against Chen as well, because he can eat the Chen creep.
Yep.
I like that pick a lot. It's pretty decent. And once again, I think synergizes pretty well with the Batrider, the Blink, Lasso. You get that one target, someone important like the Invoker, doom him up, and you basically delete him from a game, from the team fight, or from the game for a while.
I kind of like Ursa here. Reserve time. Not the worst thing if you get doomed. It's not ideal, but it's also like kind of not the worst. He can get the Enrage off possibly before the Lasso pops in. Like, there's a lot of stuff that you have to deal with right now as whatever core that you're going to be going with. And I don't know many others who are going to be able to handle all that pressure. Like, I want to say Gyro, but I don't think they'll have enough single target burst to actually kill the Spectre. Lycan.
I mean, another hero that doesn't mind getting doomed as long as you're in your ultimate form.
Mm-hmm.
I guess that's...
It is a lot of single target damage too, actually. That is pretty solid.
Yeah, and the Wolves will do a lot of work against the Doom just because Doom has no armor.
Yeah.
I guess the early heal, well, I guess actually does okay against Darkseer as well.
Yeah, I mean, their push is insane, right? Like, one of the better things is that the Lycan versus Darkseer in lane, it's kind of like the Juggernaut, except it's the opposite sense where, like, instead of just healing through the Iron Shell, it's a counter in the other way where your damage, you're like, your right-click is just so high that you just bring the Wolves in and just immediately try and kill off the Iron Shell as fast as you can. Once the Wolves are a higher level, it's easier because you can just kill the Iron Shell, move the Wolves, they're going to regen back up, and come in and do it again, like, every time.
Yeah. Here we are. Game number two now. Tearing versus WG.Unity, WG.Unity even with the one game advantage. Let's see if Tearing can bring it back.
Well, they're going to start out getting a little bit aggressive here. They have the smoke up, so... I don't know, they don't have, like, the best level one, though. Like, there's no Tusk here. There's, like, Dagger. I mean, Ice needs to be in front. He's their only control. This is really strange. I'm not sure how I feel about this.
I guess, I mean, like, if you can get the jump... I mean, yeah, in a 5v5 engagement, they're not great, but it's unlikely, or they're probably not thinking that they're going to come across five heroes. They just need to come across one or two, and then they can easily kill them. My guess. Ice is now in the lead, like you said. Magic Missile on the ready. Arrows being used to ping out. They get him Silver Ward down, but Lycan is sitting very close to that bottom tree line. But they're waiting up on the high ground for now. They have a bunch of wards. A couple of sentries now. They might think about blocking up some camps. Stop that Chen having such a easy time in the jungle.
Yeah, I'm surprised they didn't drop more, because that's certainly the whole plan of this, I would have imagined. But they just want to spot the rotation to the Chen. And you can see the Radiant, just no idea where they are. They are correct. They were in there. Just a little bit late now. So they'll get the bottom rune and the Radiant. Maybe they won't make it to top in time. Are they going to lose it on both?
I got the dagger, that will be some extra move speed, but it's not going to be enough actually. So, easy grab for the Invoker, and no stun from the Ventral Spirit, not quite in range. What was that? Invoker. Oh no, Batrider got the bot rune.
Yeah.
So, 100 rune going the way of both the mid laners. And what is this Batrider mount?
Oh, I don't know, it's freaky. There's a couple, like, mechanical. Is that one of those mechanical ones? Yeah, there's a couple of those. They're pretty cool.
Yeah. Doing off his stuff, his bragging rights. But Doom is already weaving into the dire at the Radiant Jungle, even looking for a creep to grab. Deny that from the Chen as well. But Chen went to this the new neutral camp actually, and has got himself a centaur to help out the Nature's Prophet. It seems Doom's just waiting around to see what the Chen wants to get. Oh, he's actually going the wrong way though. And he gets pinged out. I think he must have just gone into vision as well.
Yeah, he just waltzed his way like right through.
I think he was expecting the Chen to be up here. Ideally, what he'd do is just steal the Chen and creep that Chen gets straight away after using Holy Persuasion. I guess that's the main idea. And he's going to do that now, actually, get the Centaur, I would imagine. It's an okay creep to have from the beginning, anyway. The Wall Stomp is fairly mana expensive, but can be very useful.
Afu is just... I'm not sure what he's doing. He just hasn't taken a single creep yet. I guess he's worried about the Doom, but I don't know.
Yeah. Very interesting.
He's just going to try and stack up and hope he can get a Wild Wing, I guess, and then that's just going to be his plan. Just farm away.
Doom just moves into the mid lane. Minus one armor now.
I feel like, why aren't you just killing this camp while you're here, though? I don't know. This is kind of odd. Oh, man, that stack's going to be close. I ain't got it. I don't know, at this point, this Chen needs to start doing stuff. It's 2 minutes and he hasn't gotten a single point of experience. Like, I know you didn't get your Wild Wing, but it's probably time to... Because he knows these camps are blocked, they were just getting it out, and he'll deward it now, but... Like, he needs to just grab that Satyr and start killing down that stack. Top lane. Wen. He's having a fairly good time up here.
Yeah, level 3.
Yeah, the Spectre is one of the better counters against the Nature's Prophet in lane, though. It's probably the best. Once you get up a couple levels, you're just going to be able to Spectral Dagger right over top of just the Treants and the Sprouts. So, yeah. No easy escapes.
Sunstrike.
I like that. Tries to throw the Harassing Sunstrike.
Yeah, why not? I mean, it's like, you're not really using your mana for anything else. Summon a couple of Forge Spirits, maybe. Batrider thinking about going in, but he's going to get Cold Snap to force back. He's like, no! You get back, sir, as Batrider. He really wanted to go for that, considering Invoker had a number of stacks up on him. And with a level 2
Firefly.
Yeah, it was
actually pretty sick, right? Because, like, Nana went for the... he did the Sunstrike all because of that... The stick. Just because he was able to spend all that mana, but they did grab that kill up top.
Yeah, Nature's Prophet looked like he was getting close to killing off the Vengeful Spirit, but then Doom came in. Did he use the... Well, I don't know. He might have used the War Stomp. Don't know if he did in the end, but... Either way, managed to help him get the kill as Prophet.
Oof.
About TPing him.
That was close. Uphill miss.
Yeah, Batrider got low. Did he go for it again and then just get Cold Snap up once again?
I don't even know if he was like making a real play because certainly wasn't getting low enough, but he definitely got caught up by some Cold Snaps. Well, Lycan's pretty much having the free lane down here. A good time top in the CS chat, but Darkseer also doing well, getting some lucky rolls, honestly, because he hasn't been like actually physically there. Sometimes you just got to get really lucky with your ion shells. It's a bit of a crapshoot.
Yeah.
Especially really early on, like the first two levels, you don't like guarantee the CS when like you do for like the level 3 and 4. It's like, I'd say it's about 70% of your ion shells actually kill the creep when it's like 3 or 4, but between levels 1 and 2, it's like anywhere from 10 to 20%. Like, I play a lot of Darks here, and it gets pretty frustrating.
Never lucky. Baby Rage.
Pretty much.
Darks here. He's having a pretty good lane. In the mid lane, though. How's the CS going? So Batrider on top of the CS, actually. Invoker's actually having a pretty hard time here, actually. I'm kind of surprised. Doom's looking to rotate in. He's got the Infernal Blade plus the Purge. That's the creep that, like, has a ridiculous... Is that a ridiculous move speed slow? No, that's just the Purge one.
How much one's he rocking? The Mana Burn, or...? No, that's... that. You're right. That's the one with the ridiculous move speed.
60% move speed,
like,
but...
stupidly slow.
Ugh. The Darkseer. Looks like he got trapped in by some creeps plus the wolves. The Sunstrike came down, so that's gonna be the first kill going the way of WG Unity.
Yeah, Lion just pairs up so nicely with the Chen. He doesn't have the best initiation range, but if you do manage to snag them up, obviously you go from 2.5 seconds of the Hex right into the, as you can see, 1.6 for him right now on the Earth Spike, but it would have just been the 1.1 there, and then into a War Stomp, and all the right-click damage, man. You get that Howl from the Lycan. They didn't even have to use it, so must have been a very easy kill.
I'm quite surprised by this Doom as well. This Doom has very much been He spent very little time in the jungle. He's actually just been rotating around, using Devour to get a few right clicks here and a few last hits here and there. But he's mostly trying to be find kills with the early Tranquil boots plus the Scorched Earth. Your move speed gets pretty insane, and you're pretty tanky as well.
Yeah, this is kind of the new style Doom. We don't really see this whole like just farming the jungle for the six, eight, 10 minutes and going into some of those bigger items. But instead, you're most often seeing them in the dual offlane. Whereas this time, doesn't look like he feels like they can pressure down there with just the two of them.
He is literally just rotating around. Now with the toughness aura, he's got plus 6 armor. It's the Tranquil boots as well.
Lycan is a super solid hero this patch. I think it's someone that's been pretty underrated. Like, you see him a little bit like half cheese strats. Oh, there they going down this haunt.
Yeah, they're going to try and go for this, but he's got the extra move speed. Very fast move because of the ultimate. And now they're turning this around, it seems. Actually, well, WG.Unity do lose two in the end. The Spectre continues to chase on forward. The wall gets deployed. Coming in from the Darkseer, but now the chase after the Nature's Prophet. The Surge plus the Iron Shell on the Spectre. Man, that is a lot of damage. Yes, they lose the Doom, but three kills go in the way of tearing here, bringing the score 2-4.
Yeah, and that's this whole 0-3-2 build from the Daxter coming out and helping. Because some people aren't really down with the 2 points in the Surge, but that was one of the situations where just that extra second and a half of the Surge move speed helps secure those kills. And now, what are we looking at here? Got our Batrider farming up in the mid lane. He's got, it looks like he's going straight from the Brown Boots into the Blink Dagger. I like that. It doesn't mean you have to get aggressive, but he's got the pairing of the Spectre, so if he wants to, I assume, head bottom probably. Like, you'll probably see, like, Darkseer start to rotate in, look for somebody maybe with the Doom, and try and set something up for a Haunt and a nice Blink.
Haunt's not up for 44 seconds, though. Oh, it's Batrider. Once again, zoned out by the Cold Snap. He'd love to have this Invis rune, but gonna be denied.
I thought he was gonna try the Flame Break play. He is destroying this Invoker mid. I think it's mostly just bounty runes, honestly. That's like the biggest thing I can find. Okay, and it is the last hits. Yeah, he has 20 more last hits. Okay, that's pretty insane.
Darkseid was farming the neutral creeps and nearly went down, but I'm sure he knew his limits. But yeah, you're right, this Batrider is really pulling ahead against the Invoker now. Over, about double the CS.
Like, what is this? Okay. What was that? Like, that's never gonna work. That's the whole point of Batrider. He's essentially immune to, like, the Tusk as well as the Nature's Prophet. They're just two heroes that could not gank him, relying on some sort of terrain or tree cropping.
Meanwhile, bottom lane, Darkseid's got to be careful, get swift stomped up. There's also a finger that comes through. There's a double Hadouken, so Chen gets that kill.
Oh,
now, Ventral Spirit's got to be careful here. I think she'll be okay, because the cooldown on the stomp is pretty damn long. But he's got to be really careful. Lion's showing off that finger in the first, once he hit level 6, and this tower is going to fall very quickly, and we're about to reach that 10-minute mark. And maybe... Oh, turnaround, Ventral Spirit gets the stun, but Lycan's already in that wall form. Batrider, he's going to try and grab someone. It's probably going to have to be the Chen in the end. As Chen, who does he... It looks like he was trying to send his creeps away or something like that, but... Lion goes down. Chen is going to be the next one to fall, but Batrider, the Sunstrike, he's going to dodge it, but the wolves are on his heels. He's a bat, he's flying, but he can't quite make it. Oh, the Lycan wolves managed to turn what was a disastrous fight into a fairly acceptable one, to be honest.
Yeah, level 4 wolves and... No Tranquil Boots yet means no armor there for that Batrider. It's totally crushed.
Back to after using that Horn, it's forced to TP back to this top lane. He's got no mana for the moment, but there's no way Nature's Prophet can just man fight against this Spectre. With 2 points in Desolate, 1 in Dispersion, but Tower is going to be a little bit of a fake out. Gets denied. And Nature's Prophet didn't quite manage to work that out, and now in comes the Darkseid. He's got to hold on. Actually, he doesn't have the vacuum. The wall is going to be used to give the vision the Sunstrike. It's going to just miss the Spectre. So Spectre managed to survive through that, so good gank there. Maybe the... I don't know, actually, I think there was enough damage to kill the Prophet, even if he did TP out straight away.
I think if he TP'd out, like, straight away, but he probably wasn't thinking that there wouldn't be a vacuum. He's probably waiting for it to go off.
But Haste Rune now on Invoker, chasing after Darkseid. Darkseid's pretty tanky, though. So, actually, he's just going to TP out as the Cold Snap wears out. And the Haste Rune for Invoker is going to fade fairly shortly.
One thing that we noticed about Yamate so far is that this might have been one of those games where Boots of Travel might have been better earlier on, just because like he had such a massive lead. It was what, like 8 minutes really when he was able to pick up this blink dagger? It was like 9 basically.
Yeah,
but this early on, it doesn't offer you that much. He doesn't even have maxed the points and like into the Firefly and into the sticky napalm, and you can see down bottom he didn't even use the blink. He just got on top and was like, oh, my lasso's not even worth it right now.
Yep.
Like, I wouldn't mind seeing just the faster move speed to help farming in the jungle, help farming and pushing around the map. You can tell he's going to be going for them next anyway, but like that can help accelerate you from just blink four staff into like boss blink four staff and bring those items on at a faster time.
I also quite like it against this sort of like, obviously WG.Unity will be looking to push towers. They've already taken all the T1 towers, so that means you can kind of be more efficient with your movement around the map, which you'll inevitably have to do anyway. But they're looking to try and catch a kill here. They get the Invoker. This is a big target. They don't have the Doom. He's actually got the Purge, though. They do have the Stun from the Vengeful Spirit. The Chen all heal. Not going to be enough to keep the Invoker alive.
Yeah, they even throw down the Sentry just in case. But no points in low X anyway.
Oh, yeah. Nice kill there, showing off that Blink Dagger.
That's kind of stuff you need if you're going to go for the Blink Dagger, though. So that's perfect. And that makes it totally worth it. Now up to 900 gold, well on his way to that 4 staff. What about our Darkseer? He is close to the mech. Okay, this is good. They can start to do their own little bit of like a group up and counter push. I guess now it's going to be on the Doom, and he is working on those drums. Definitely the item that you would be expecting here. I wonder if Spectre will pick up her own pair too. I might just go for the Yasha instead. We'll see.
Lion finds the Darkseer, yeah.
Yeah.
Smoke easy pays picking. Off.
How's he doing anyway? Yeah, 1,000 gold on its way to the blink.
Lycan's in the Roshan pit doing Lycan things. He's got the medallion plus the Vlad's just already finished medallion. Up.
Oh, this is like hurting my brain to watch. Click your medallion. Guys,
why is
please.
He not using it? Yeah, I know it does. Doesn't it do part. Half to Roshan now, but
there
still
we go.
Worth it.
It only does half, but it's still good.
Okay, he must have been looking elsewhere on the map for sure. Well, busy controlling his wolves, actually, probably. But down to half HP now. Still gone unnoticed. He did smoke in there, remember? But the Sunstrike's going to come out. Oh, okay. That's an allied Sunstrike. It's fine. It's fine. Meanwhile, in the top lane,
yeah,
though.
I got freaked out for a second, too. I was like, oh, he's so screwed.
Batriders are going to try and TP his way out of here. Lion moving in to try and catch the Hex. Not going to be in range. And still, Lycan continues to try and take this down. He's lost one of his wolves. Does have a resummon in 2 seconds, though, so not the biggest deal. Does remember to use the medallion this time, so it looks like he's going to be able to take this without any issues. Chen's going to move in just in case. More Sunstrike to try and help out, and 13 minutes into this game, Lycan solos the Roshan.
Alright, here we go then. So that's kind of a little bit of a bounce back for Warriors. You know, with this whole Batrider getting a little control in the Spectre, this will be a nice safeguard in the next fight. Radiance middle tower
is being attacked. Yeah.
2,300 gold. Is he going to go for the Radiance build? I mean, he's really rich already. What's their team? Okay, actually, you know what? It's an Invoker. It's a Lycan. Okay, why didn't they pick Earthshaker?
Yeah.
Can you imagine how good Earthshaker would be in this game?
Yeah.
But the Doom did do a lot of work. I'm not hating. Either way. I mean, he would have like probably a Blink Dagger by now, but anyway, it's fine, it's fine. It'd be like super unlikely, but it's definitely a Radiance game. If that's something that you're comfortable with, look at all these summons. Like, it's going to be very valuable.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. And I don't know about you, I kind of feel like WG need to maybe group up now. They've got the Aegis. They want to try and, you know, take this early game, get some more tower gold to boost up their net worth. But
yeah, they're kind of at that point where like they're ahead in net worth because of the towers, but it's hard to tell how much of that is tower and how much that's actual value. They do get the kill top.
Yeah, that was a blink lasso plus the Spectre coming in to help get the kill, and it's gonna hold the push for another 30 seconds probably.
Yeah, full four staff now done as well though.
I had a feeling this was a comfort pick for them, why they, considering they picked up in the first phase, and it's definitely doing some work. 2-1 and 3 now, 87 CS, and the Blink 4 staff 15 minutes into this game. Pretty neat.
Yeah, I don't know, I'm just like a big fan of Batrider. A lot of teams that do prioritize it, it's just because the hero, it's so exceptionally well if you have someone who's even halfway decent on it. Like, for the most part of Dota Pit, Batrider was even banned in the first phase in a lot of games. Even against teams that aren't really that well known for it, I think it's still a strong hero. They're trying with the smoke here.
Alright, it is up on the high ground though, so it's actually just gonna TP the hell out of there. He senses something was going on. That's sixth sense, man. He was prepared. Chen does have a big army of creeps now, so it looks like they're gonna barrel down this mid lane. Look at all these summons. Earthshaker, please.
Yeah, pretty much. It's just like, I don't know, the space is, it's being made as well. Like, they're wasting a little bit of time there on the Batrider. They're probably going to lose this tower. Unlikely they can do much about it, but that relic is so close. The Radiance is coming.
Powerful, quickly. Do they look to go high ground? Still got the Aegis for quite a while. And, you got to remember, they've got to worry about the Batrider. He's got a 4 stuff now. They might not be aware of this as well, so he can be a lot safer moving in. Doom's got his ultimate. I hate saying Doom has Doom, so just called his ultimate now. Spectre continuing to farm very carefully, sending out the courier to now get that relic.
They really need some wards down. They're spotting out some of these rotations, and I think the Chen's being a little bit sloppy, just because like you do get the tower vision all the way to there during the daytime, so the Dire are just watching them like rotating through here, and they're going to show anyway, but they're now smoking up because they know this is coming, so they have lots of ample time to prep and could see the Batrider with a nice loop around.
Yep. Who does he grab though?
Come out, though?
I guess the Invoke is probably the best target, but he's got to watch out the line. He goes for the Chen to stop the heals coming down. In fact, they doom him up as well. The vacuum wall catching out a large number of heroes, but the game, he gets paused. Oh, Lycan in some issues as he hangs. So Chen's dead, that's for sure, right?
I mean, he's doomed anyway, so it doesn't matter. Yeah. Even if he lives, it won't be time for the items to become effective.
Doom's kind of in the middle of it all the moment. I think he'll probably end up dying, but Lycan's taken a bit of a beating already.
It's so hard to tell.
We're going. Let's do this. Who's going to end up going down? Yes, the Chen dies, but the finger comes through, finishing off the Doom as Lycan's going to sprint himself away. He doesn't really want to try and turn because he's actually got the napalm on and jump forward from Batrider. Doesn't quite manage to get the extra damage out, but Invoker going to pay with his life here. And in fact, Batrider caught inside the tree lines, but the swap is going to save him. Very good work there, but he's being chased after by a bunch of creeps. The right clicks the Hadouken. It comes through. They finish him off with a shockwave, and now Lycan's going to TP out. They don't have any stun for him. Oh, WG Unity managed to scrape out a sort of even trade there.
Oh, man. All right. Looking good. It doesn't matter, though, because Spectre got 361 gold, so that Radiance is just about done.
Yeah. I mean, I still think Tearing won that team fight, but it could have been so much worse for WG Unity. They could have gone 4-for-1 in that trade, but instead it was 3-for-2.
Pause is messing with my brain. I couldn't even tell what was killing the Batrider in the middle of that fight. It looked like he was dying to like an iron shell. I was getting so confused. I was like, the Darkseer's on the other team?
I think it was mostly wolves.
About to run through a wall? It's those creeps beating away on him. And so now we have left here. Oh man, this Radiance is going to be so good. Doom could go in towards like that Blink Dagger just to make sure he can keep getting on top of that Chen without needing to commit the lasso.
Oh, he's in some trouble though. The Cold Snap, the Meteor. No, not going to go for this. As Vengeful Spirit gets spotted out, they could. Well, there's no Doom, so there's no way they could go on this. But Spectre has got a Haunt up in 23 seconds. A swap from the from the Nature's Prophet pretty good. Is Vengeful just going to TP out of there? Warriors Gaming playing it pretty safe. Worried about the Batrider coming in. And rightly so, to be honest.
So now, what is it? Is it up yet? It's so close to being this Haunt. Like, I just want to get on the move. I want them to just smoke right now on the side of Tearing and just make the best possible use of this Radiance. Like, I wouldn't even want to show it off.
But they got, yeah, they got Doom ready now
so
as well.
They'll be aware.
Man, you hardly see Medallion anymore, and currently there's two in the game.
Is there one on the Venge? Oh, there is two. That is pretty comical. I guess just because it's all about the right clicks this game, for the most part. Like, just through the Lycan, the Nature's Prophet. So, it's going to be helping him out.
So, on the net worth graph, it's actually pretty much even. It's been a pretty crazy up and down ride, but pretty much sitting at zero. XP is going Tearing's way, though, 3k. Which is a sizable amount. It's probably, you can factor that into the extra 5 kills that they have.
This is so scary now, because we talk about, like, it looked like Warriors Gaming, they need to kind of group up and start pushing in, but now if you do that and the haunt gets turned on you.
Yeah. This is like, it's like
it. Yeah, the finger. Sunstrike.
Oh, nice. Once again, this Invoker-Lion combo. They seem to have perfected this, especially as Lion now has the Blink Dagger, and they can move into this top lane. Lycan, not Lycan, even the Nature's Prophet moving up to this top lane. Teleports in fact. I'm not lying, Lycan is moving to the top lane as well. With the Mithril Hammer, do you think this is a Deso or a BKB?
Probably just the BKB. Pretty normally necessary, I think.
Pick up the Ogre Club first, though, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I know. I guess it kind of depends. I'm not sure how I feel about a Deso, really. Like, there's just so many better items that you need. Like, I don't think you can commit to a Deso because you still, I would say, still like go into your AC. Probably your Boots of Travel later on anyway, because you are a Lycan. Pretty important stuff there. And BKB just seems like such a necessity on the hero.
Sure, yeah. Yeah, it's going to be a BKB. He's got the Ogre Club now. He was just falling with us.
Just goofing.
Yeah, been pretty quiet apart from that one little pick-off and a tower push now. Only one T2 tower left on the Dire side. The Radiant, they've only just lost the one tower, so it's untapped gold, actually, for tearing, but it's also map control that they don't have. Checking out the Roshan.
They have picked up that gem, so the Boots Travel will be delayed on the Batrider, but of course it means that they can start taking a grip on this map, you know, clean out their own jungle eventually. Head into the enemy one right now, spotted some wolves.
They're actually in the enemy jungle, but not going to find anyone. Darks here. Opted to go for the Guardian Greaves over the Blink Dagger first.
I like that. I think it's just because the way these fights are going to go. Like, his initiation isn't that required with the way the Batrider is going to be playing the fights. The way that, like, Spectre gives you all this nice vision, it still lets you set up for some pretty easy vacuums. And then the way, like, the fight's going to go, that they come in, the Radiant starts burning down Warriors Gaming, the Haunt, you know, it's doing the right-click damage the whole time, especially once he gets into that Diffusal Blade or the Manta. And after that, they're going to pop the Hand of God. And then that's their chance to win the fight. Like, right after they pop the Hand of God, they need to, like, blow up a really big target on tearing and start, you know, whittling through them. But the Guardian's Greaves are just going to be... it's going to make it so hard for them. Like, the amount of healing that's going to be coming from the Darkseer and the damage coming out from the Spectre combined just seems... it almost seems insurmountable for Warriors Gaming, because it's 5-on-5, but I come up with the smoke now.
Rumble in the jungle time. There's Invoker. Is he going to get doomed up? So he can't get anything off, but Doom is going to die straight after that. The BKB from Lycan completed. He's just going to be chasing off this Batrider who got the lasso onto the Chen. So he already uses hit or heal. No mechanism. So it's a 1-for-1 trade-off at the moment. And I think we're just going to leave. Or maybe not leave it at that. Flame Break going to push the Nature's Prophet. He's going to try and TP out, but the swap is there. So 2-for-1 now, another kill going the way of Spectre. So he's on a dominating streak, up to 2,800 gold. That looked like it was going to be a bigger fight than it actually was.
Yeah, that Doom just like, that could have been so much worse for tearing if they hadn't Doomed the Invoker. Actually, yeah, just way too deep right now.
What's he doing? Plays.
He's got it in 1 second, he's got Firefly.
He'll be all right. Meanwhile, in the bottom lane, they're chasing after Invoker. Spectre gets another kill. Was there no Ghost Walk or anything?
I guess so. Must have already invoked or something. It looks like he tried to get the kill with the Meteor and the Deafening Blast.
Yeah. Yasha complete. Manta not going to be too far away now. And I honestly feel like this is Tering's game to lose at this stage of the game. WG.Unity weren't able to apply enough pressure early on to stop the Spectre getting a really well-timed Radiance. And she's only gonna get fatter and fatter. I'm not trying to say this game's over or anything, but it's definitely heading Tearing's way.
Yeah, it does look like they have the advantage here. And with the Batrider and the Radiance, it's much harder for them to get back into inside of Warriors Gaming. They just need that Invoker to not get doomed. I mean, it really is that simple. And then the next Roshan, again, it can be one of those things that can turn this game around, but with the Haunt almost back up, look at Sionix. He's just walking around with the Radiance. He's turning it off while he makes this walk. I don't know if he's just trying to not steal Batrider's creep or if he's just trying to not let them know that he's running in. It's some pretty random ass plays, honestly. Like toggling Radiance.
Yeah, I guess the one thing that WG.Unity can you can say for them is the fact that if they do win a team fight, they can take down buildings very, very quickly. And considering there's very well, there's only one T2 tower left. They win a team fight, they're looking at possibly two sets of racks. Maybe.
Perhaps. Yeah.
There's a smoke up Batrider, Vengeful Spirit, Doom, walking down this, walking up to the river actually, over towards the new, the ancient creeps. They're gonna wrap around behind this T1 tower in the top lane, hoping to find these three heroes. They're gonna have to be a bit more patient though if they want to try and find anyone. Batrider up on the high ground, being a flying ward for now, pops the Firefly, but this gank is not gonna work out for them. There's everyone on the Radiant, they managed to get themselves out of there.
Yeah, Warriors Gaming are playing this very well. Like, they're starting to split the map up, and I mean, I still feel like tearing hit this game, but I do feel like they need to actually do something, because if they don't force this advantage they have right now, like, yeah, the Spectre's going to keep getting bigger and bigger, but when the Lycan gets up into things like the Assault Carass and the Invoker gets into these bigger items like the Aghanim Scepter, like your Octarine Core, like, those aren't that far away. They seem far away, but with the Midas and Boots of Travel, like, it's 26 minutes now, and he just picked up the Point Booster, but he already has almost another 1,000 gold. That Aghanim Scepter could be here even before 30 minutes, and that changes the complexity of the fight immensely. Like, if he's not doomed, there's not that much hard lockdown. Like, maybe he gets lassoed, but...
Do you feel like he should have gone for, like, a Link or something?
On the, Evoker? The Evoker? I think Eggs is just too good. It would be nice if you were someone like a Morphling or someone that can rely on just your right-click damage and stuff like that, but the Aghanim Scepter is just probably like one of the best upgrades in the game after all the reworks and everything.
Okay. And you actually see good. Darkseid go for a 4-star over the Blink Dagger, just because, like you said earlier, he's not needed for initiations, and it's a much better item against the Prophet. Just because you can 4-star yourself or an ally that gets trapped in the Sprout.
Yeah. That's very solid.
Or Hexed, or something like that.
You can also do double 4-staff on your Batrider. It's pretty huge. I don't know, this Lycan. I'm a pretty big proponent of Lycan. I actually thought for the past two patches that he was going to have like a really big surge, and both times I was very surprised. I said the same thing about Tiny, to be honest, and I'm still counting on that. That's next patch. But either way, I think this hero is so broken. Like, even back at TI, was that 4? I don't even remember. Whatever it was for RTZ, like, they were the only ones picking Lycan, but they were destroying with it. And yeah, No one else was really going for the hero, and everyone would just first ban it against them, but it's just like, why aren't you doing it yourself, you know? And it's the same thing with Tiny right now. Everyone first bans Tiny versus Complexity. Like, all your top teams, e.g., first ban, like, Tiny Bounty Hunter versus. But, like, why isn't anyone picking
in the Roshan pit? They're not going to be able to get. Not gonna be able to snag the Runin. Oh, Spectre's gonna be careful. Nearly gets locked down by the Central Conqueror.
That's pretty huge for them, right? Just get that nice Aegis.
We'll have to look for more Lycans and Tinies in the future, then.
That's right. You just think of me every time.
I will.
Be like, Mopax was right. But he's getting up in towards that Assault Crass. I have to imagine that'll be the item. It's just so good, especially with their squad. Like, he's definitely gonna be the one to get it. They've gone for the Aghanim Scepter on the Nature's Prophet, which is a little bit controversial. I think some people wouldn't be a big fan up against like Batrider and Spectre, because it seems like they can just push that out really easily. Like, if they all start coming in with these Treants, it's just going to be like, oh, Radiance, don't care. Thanks for the extra gold, Nature's Prophet.
Wink. Yoink.
Yeah, like, that's 40 gold. That's kind of crazy when you think about it.
That's why I sometimes think, like, the Axe Refresher on Nature's Prophet can almost like be a hindrance. I've seen games where not only does it feed your enemy lots of gold, but it takes away so much gold from your allies as well.
Yeah, it does. That's a good point. Like, the way it pushes the map just non-stop, it makes it so much harder for your supports and particularly like your offlaners to keep getting a lot of farm. Same thing with like a core Naga, right? You just get starved. You're like starving the enemy in some sense, but you're mostly just starving your own team.
That's why I'm really not a big advocate of the Axe Octarine. I mean, I'm sure it's good in some like a few situations, but and maybe this game is one of them, but
Like, there was a time where every single Nature's Prophet went phase drums eggs. It was like for a full like month and a half in Pro Dota, every single Nature's Prophet. It was getting ridiculous. And now we're seeing a lot more people go back to the Orchid. The Maelstrom has become increasingly popular too, just because it adds that push element as well as the damage. And there is that Diffusal. So he did finish out the full Manta first. I honestly wondered if he was just going to go for Yasha Diffusal just because of how helpful it's going to be in these team fights. But now having both, obviously that's the dream. The Manta Diffusal, like the anti-mage cosplay. So expect you're ready to rock it out here.
You seen this Radiant Observer ward up on the high ground here?
That's a cheeky one, eh?
Yeah.
Just going to stop that Nature's Prophet. You can do this with Lycan too. Like, you'll come to the tree, summon your wolves, stuff like that. So.
It's the Radiant one, so...
Oh, right. I guess he's just hoping for the bat, right? All right, yeah, that's pretty weird for it being the Radiant.
I mean,
someone's going to be walking there, I guess, but...
My only thought is the fact that they're doing it just because it's not going to get dewarded by the gem, which the Batrider has, or extremely unlikely to be anyway. Like, who's going to check up there? So they can't put the sort of traditional wards, you know, in sort of anywhere around here just because the Batrider will eventually deward them. Or whoever has the gem at the moment. I believe it's still... Batrider's still got the gem. So, in that respect, yes, it's a less efficient ward, but it's one that's going to at least give you some information and not get dewarded. As Chen's finished up the Aghanims, and he's going to recall his creeps, but, wow, they took a fair bit of a beating there. And still, this has been a very quiet game for the last 10 minutes or so. I think maybe one or two kills, and that's about it. Both teams continue just to farm up.
And I think that's favoring Warrior Gaming, really. Like, they've got this big dual core of the Lycan as well as the Invoker.
Ooh.
Whereas it's just Spectre.
It's an unfortunate lag as Invoker.
I mean, it was a pretty weird blink.
Yeah.
Let's be honest. Like, he could have certainly blinked on top of them. There's no reason he couldn't have.
Yeah, I think this might be Invoker dead. Looks like there might be some server issues. My ping, like, yeah, my ping's sharp as well. Actually, saying that, this is a Malaysian server anyway, so I'm gonna have high ping anyway. Duh. Or a Singapore server, I guess, actually. But let's see what happens to this Evoker. Oh, he blinks away, but the Haunt, the Spectre's gonna come, and he's just gonna TP out invisible.
So
the vacuum's not gonna work either.
Oh, it's like, oh look, a lion was just sitting up top.
Oh yeah.
Just hides on top of him. Oh man.
Lion's he's like, sitting there for ages as well.
It looks like Yamate. Oh, okay, he didn't go for a lasso play. Yeah. He was just on top of Afu.
Yeah, and Voka is looking to move on forward, but Batrider's got a lot of speed. There's the Doom catching up the Nature's Prophet. Now the Lasso. There's an EMP. It's going to remove some of their mana. It's not a huge amount of mana, but Nature's Prophet, he's got the backup of his allies. There comes the Channel Heal. He's just going to get sent back to base. Nice work there. The Ice Wall going to be put down, so Batrider, they just can't chase. He blinks over the top of it, though, but his allies are a bit too far away at the moment. Chen being slowed down a little bit, but the Meteor's coming down. Chen, he's dead, but they do lose the Batrider in the end as well. And Doom trapped inside the tree line. Sunstrike going to come down here on the Darkseer. Now the right click's coming out from from Nana. He's trying to do what he can, running forward. But Darkseer is pretty tanky, especially with the Guardian Greaves.
Lycan saved the day.
Lycan coming in now, chasing off the Darkseer. But you got to remember Spectre. He deals a lot of damage to Forstaff down. And now Lycan trapped on this high ground, trying to man fight against the Spectre here. But this is a Spectre you're trying to fight again. But the ally Invoker comes in to try and do what he can. But doesn't matter. The Radiance Burn is enough. Spectre getting cold snapped up, chased after by these creeps. But he's just the Aegis. Ice Wall put right on top of him. Lion is here with all the disables in the world. You can need the Sunstrike. He's going to need to stun them. There's the Finger coming through. Spectre isn't that tanky, and he's going to use the his Manta. He's still alive. He's going to need to walk underneath the tower, but this doesn't do so much damage. He's on 67, 30 hit points. One more right click turned into a frog, and he goes down. Oh, they nearly didn't have that.
That would have been disastrous if they didn't at least get that kill.
Especially as Invoker bought back there. So a 4-for-3 trade-off.
Yeah, so still going to be favoring Tearing. Mostly the Doom, 1,000 gold for him. Had himself a doozy of a fight. What's he going for? He's got his blink. He can go for like the Shiva's Guard next. Yeah, it's definitely going to be Shiva's Guard. Unless he wants like a counter AC under the assumption that Lycan will pick one up here. Actually, what did he grab? Yeah, it is the AC. It's done now. But Shiva's just like so good. Oh, they're bringing someone in here. Invoker's coming down. But he's right in the middle of three heroes. Oh, what a quick tornado. Woo! Nana with the script tax. Yo, that was close.
Outrider, I guess he's going for BKB now with the Oak Club.
Yeah, that should be his item. Just the Invoker. Too frustrating to deal with. Oh, Darkseid is going to get the Shiva's Guard. Well, that's nice. So then maybe Doom doesn't have to. So he's still going to have to just think about his item then. I think I like the AC for him.
Yeah. You think Arm is probably the way to go. The only other option would possibly be an Aghanim Scepter, but it's not so good anymore.
Yeah. Back in the old day, it would have been pretty nice. You know what? It wouldn't be that bad, honestly, just for the Invoker because of the time. Because I do get the Bat mid.
Yeah, okay, Batrider's dead.
Yeah, that's a couple of units there, I think. The Chaos Dunk, man, where is it? Anyway. Yeah, I kind of like the eggs, frankly. It's a little bit, like, it's not that great anymore. It's not like it's just a duh, pick it up every single game. But yeah. If you get it on the Invoker, it would at least force him to really retreat from the fight and not just hang out the whole time. Well, he could go for the BKB instead. That's totally fine as well. Just make sure you get the Doom on the best target.
Yeah. Because of Yamate's death, though, he dropped the gem. That's going to go the way of Lion. And they're going to get a D ward right about now. AC complete. You're right. I think WG Unity, they're doing okay, to be honest. Net worth. They've got a net worth. Oh, no. Taring have the net worth lead. It's only 2K, though.
I think Warriors Gaming are going to win this game. I actually don't believe in Taring anymore. I think they've squandered their lead for too long. Like, the power spike that they had, it's waning very quickly. And I just don't feel like the Spectre is going to be able to solo carry this game. Like, the Batrider is going to lose a lot of his effectiveness.
Oh, Chen. Oh, is Chen going to get out of this? There's a blink too far forward from Doom, but the swap's going to bring him into his open demonic arms. They get the kill, but that was almost not a kill.
Well, there's the Haunt. Lion, no! Oh, he lives. They both immediately TP home. They just brought in the Lion, so they will survive.
Oh, and no, dude. What was... Oh, no, Spectre. What was Spectre doing there? Was he chasing after the Lion?
Yeah. Mistakes were made. I think the Lion, instead of TPing home, he accidentally TP'd here. Or unless he did it on purpose to bait it into the Invoker. And if so, well played. But costing the Spectre his life. Yeah, yeah. I've lost faith.
Only misplay there.
Like, if it was any other mid, I wouldn't be feeling as bad about this game. But Batrider, as a mid, he does do really well early. Like, he saw the Blink Dagger. You see how much damage comes out from the Firefly. But that ends up being it. Like, there's nothing else to add. As he gets further and further in terms of items, he doesn't really stack on any more damage, and that's a big problem. It's just still the same spells. It's just, you know, that doesn't scale the best later on. It's not like a Queen of Pain that can go like an AC Maelstrom or something like that. She's going to be adding on a lot of damage. It's really starting to fall off. And what else do you have? You have a Darkseer who's another offlaner. He's not like a Nature's Prophet where he can scale the damage items as well. Mm-hmm. So, at least he will find this Nature's Prophet.
Hey, he TP'd in a very dodgy position. I think he thought he was safe. He gets an Observer Ward down, but
yeah,
that was dangerous. Tornado, EMP. He's going to force back Tearing away from this tower, which is being molested down. But the Dire, they're going to try and catch someone out. There's just too many units in the way, though. Get out of my face. Invoker's actually waiting here as well. I don't know whether they're thinking about reinitiating here. Maybe not. So yeah, Prophet. Yes, he did. He kind of... It was almost a distraction TP, you know? It's like... Yes, you got a kill, but there's now no outer towers left for Tearing. They lose a team fight. They lose a lot of their base. Spectre's just going to horn in. They're going to try and find the Invoker. They have the gem. I know someone rebought the gem. I think it was the Doom. But he's moved off towards the right-hand side. Invoker's just going to TP out of there. Meanwhile, they do find, though, the Chen.
Yeah, they actually left it on the courier. It looks like he's just waiting for the bat to grab it. Probably waiting for the BKB to be done before bringing it out.
And Roshan's respawned, so it's a pretty nice timing to find that pickoff. It nearly gets snagged as well by the like from Wolf actually here, but it's going to move in, but it'll probably just take too much damage and won't survive long enough. Saying that, Roshan is falling pretty quickly with the Medallion of Courage, plus the DD on the Spectre, the Zeus Ult, oh, not the Zeus Ult, the Nature's Prophet Ultimate, the Wrath of Nature, bouncing around. Now the Forge Spirit's moving in. I don't think they're actually going to move in for this. The Tornado coming through, are they? Are they? The Meteor, the EMP, the Deafening Blast, the BK Force from Doom, but they get the grab onto the Invoker. They could use the Doom if they wanted to, but they don't need to. They blow him up quickly. But Nature's Prophet ratting it out in the top lane. Yes, the Aegis will end up falling. It's Cheese as well. So Spectre picks up the Aegis. Cheese going the way of Vengeful Spirit for now. Obviously can hand that off a bit later, but T3 Tower down to 282 health in the top lane for the Dire side.
I mean, what did Nana think was going to happen? They have a Batrider. Like, I don't know what that play is. Like, you're not going to do anything. It's five heroes taking a Roshan. You're fully aware it's five heroes taking a Roshan. You just had a Wolf and four Spirits going in. That's a very silly play. And that's the kind of stuff that could, like, actually make it so Terran could potentially win this game, but the way they've been playing, I actually think, like, I really still believe that Warriors Gaming had an advantage, even if they were just going to lose a free Aegis, but deaths like that, it's going to really slow down the Invoker, because he could be pressuring so far, like, down here right now, if he didn't just die for no reason.
Yeah.
And that's for still 40 more seconds, and I'm still complaining about it. It's clearly it's a big death.
Lion, he's hiding out here at the moment. He should be safe. There's no way that they can see him.
I mean, you might have thought about that, or thought that about that Nature's Prophet down bottom, too.
That's true. And there is a Spectre Haunt as well. Spectre Haunts now. Be dangerous, but there's no reason for Spectre Haunt at the moment. He's going for the Butterfly now.
Surprised he doesn't have the Glimmer on the line. I like the Force Staff, too, but Glimmer is one of those items that can be really handy against Spectre. Also, how did he die top that time after the Haunt? Because now that I think about it, he was down bottom for so long that you'd think he would have been able to hex up the illusion. Maybe he TP'd immediately. Oh. That might have been what it was, but either way.
Oh, Batrider looking to grab someone if he can. He can't choose on the right target. He does finally find the Nature's Prophet there with the Haunt in. They can blow him up. That'll be big. The Chen using his ultimate. They're the Hand of God bringing him up, and Nature's Prophet isn't dead just yet. Where is he? Oh, he managed to teleport all the way back to base. And now BKB on Lycan just wearing off as he's chasing off the Spectre. The extra move speed is really going to help with that. Now the Cold Snap locking him down. Remember, he's got the Aegis, though. The Sunstrike is going to miss, and Spectre's going to turn and fight this because he knows he's got the extra life. Batrider could move in, but no Flaming Lasso. And it's a really good trees actually blocking out the swap. He's going to catch out the Nature's Prophet, and Spectre turned into a frog, but in comes Batrider laying down the flames. This Ice Wall is actually doing a really good job stopping Spectre from chasing, but now gets the dagger onto the Lycan as Lycan's gonna get chased after. So it's three dead on the Radiant side. Tearing doing this at the moment, although Vengeful Spirit taking a lot of damage here from the Wolves, plus the
nice
Forge Spirits.
He's looking after that Lion Yamate. Got him. That's pretty well done.
Alright, nice, yeah. But he's actually running away, worried about the Finger of Death, but the burn. That's Gem of True Sight on the deck, and I don't think they realize that, but Tearing, they just want to end this game here and now. There are buybacks, actually. This is going to be hard to end. They do have the cheese. They did hand off the cheese to him. This T3 tower starts to take a beating. This will be obviously one of the better lanes to push in at the moment because their own base has been damaged a little bit in that lane. Meteor coming down. Deafening Blast. They're going to move in. Was that buyback from the Lycan? It must have been. It was. And they're just going to try and blow up the Spectre. But Spectre eats the cheese. Still alive for now. And that's going to be the death of the Invokers. He's going to buy back. Lycan having to retreat himself away from there. And I think the Dire are just going to get themselves out of there. Tornado, not going to be enough.
So that all started with the Nature's Prophet. It was him who got lassoed under the tower and managed to survive?
Yeah, it was actually. He did.
Yeah, and then Warriors Gaming, though, the chase. Like, it was kind of a crazy play. Like, they used the Haunt. They managed to stop it all, and they weren't going to die anymore, and Nature's Prophet lived, but then they chased, and it's understandable why to chase and why to get kills, knowing that the Haunt was down, but the rest of the side of Terran just coming in, and they didn't have that numbers advantage anymore underneath their own tower, and kind of threw away a little bit of that fight there, but they'll have that Scythe now, and another tool to try and bring down the Spectre, but you can see them struggling. It was through Aegis and through Cheese, though, so hopefully the next time will go better, but she's sitting on 3k gold.
Yeah, and there's going to be a Hex completed for the Dark, so he doesn't actually got buyback as well. That's pretty neat. Is that gem still on the down? It's still a gem here. The one that Lion dropped after he died.
Yeah. Yeah, it's kind of funny. I wonder if they know, like, because his inventory was full. Either way.
Smoke up from the radiant side.
WG clearly don't know, or else they'd be sending out the courier.
All five heroes from WG. They're going to move in, or do they ping it out? They know where they are. They see the Spectre, they want to try and grab her, but Batrider is going to completely spot this out. Use the BKB. He decides to turn and grab. It's going to be the Lycan, actually, so if they can blow him up quick, that would be great. The Doom, he used that BKB. Can't decide. Actually, doesn't have Doom yet. Up in 20 more seconds. Lycan's still alive, using that BKB. No one dead, apart from the Chen now on the Radiant side. The swap, very long range swap, catching out the Invoker. It is a level 3 swap, so they get that pick off as well. He's got no buyback in Lion. He's just going to run himself up towards the northwest, towards the secret shop.
So, it's under a ward, though. Oh, no, he's not. Yeah, he was. Okay, it's just, like, super small.
Well, great fight there for terroring the... they didn't expect the Batrider to come in, and he BKB'd very quickly and managed to grab a very important target.
Yeah, it seems like they finally hit the... like, they're actually getting the fights, and they're doing well in executing in them. The Nana just not having the same impact that he had last game. Probably just because of the fact that it's gone a little bit later, and there's all these BKBs up on Terran that they are using. Exceptionally well as when gets doomed up.
Yeah, he's in a lot of trouble. Doom, Batrider's flying over the top of him. Lion does, however, very quickly TP out, and that's a straight buyback from Prophet. He realizes he's going to be needing the fight. He sees bottom lane is pushing in quite nicely, so he's just going to TP to this bottom lane and apply pressure where he can. But he's got to be careful not to die again. Meanwhile, mid lane being pressured by Tearing. They've already taken the top lane. Yes, there's still a melee, a ranged barrack standing, but it doesn't really matter too much. They're not going to focus onto the
melee
barracks.
They're going to try and counter push.
There's no Invoker, though, to defend.
And now the lasso on the Nature's Prophet, the TPing back. He's going to have Scythe.
Yamate is a flying pig with the burning from the ass, but now he's going to try and TP out, but Nature's Prophet is not going to survive through that. But. Was that Lycan? Lycan did manage to TP out though, but they lose their mid lane, or their mid barracks, so about to lose the range barracks as well. So, nearly two full sets of barracks down inside the Radiant base, and a good defense inside there, and Tearing zone base as well.
Yeah, it looks like Tearing are starting to close this one out. Looking good. A basher coming in on a Spectre.
Wow.
That's kind of fun. I mean, he's got everything else, really. Not much else you'd really need.
Yeah, well, I mean,
going
what do you like? Maybe
it's going to be pretty handy.
Heart would be the other option, but it's got pretty decent attack speed with the Butterfly Manta and the Diffusal Blade, so I like the basher a lot.
Yeah, they needed to just hold that Lycan in place, especially through all these BKBs.
Bearing, they've just got one more objective until Megas. Hmm. I think this should be a fairly easy take for them. Oh, especially when Spectre has a DD rune and got the Haunt up. They move on forward. They're probably just going to... Batrider's going to just try and grab a target right here, right now. In fact, there's Creep Wave spotting him out, though. Just grab one target. But look at Prophet. Back towards his like the bottom lane. He's just going to push out the lanes as much as possible. Use that Wrath of Nature. Halt the push where possible. Stop Tearing, taking this last...
That's only one wave,
line
though.
...line of defense. Yeah.
What do they have left? They need to, like, meatball his wave or something and just get that backdoor protection up.
Yeah, mid and top lane are kind of safely in a fairly safe position at the moment. Sunstrike going to come down, hits on no one at the moment, but here comes Sionix attacking down the tower. Where's Batrider? He's going to be looking at the tornado.
Creep so badly.
And now Batrider's got the Firefly back up. He's going to look, try and grab someone, the EMP. Who does he get? He's just going to grab the Lion, four staff himself away. I'll respect ultimate. Batrider is turned into, once again, a flying piggy, but... It doesn't matter. They get the kill on the line. The vacuum is not going to catch anyone. But look how much damage Spectre is doing. He's just killing everyone. Three kills. Triple kill for him. And GG is called. We're going to a game number 3. Okay.
All right, well, Tearing. They got the Spectre. They played it well. And much better than the first game. So pretty impressed with that. Yamate on that Batrider. Like, it's hard to remember just because the last 20 minutes or so, he hasn't been the most impactful just by the nature of the hero. But he really secured that first, like, 25 minutes for them. Amazing time in the mid lane, tons of last hits, so impressed by his performance there. Had a lot of great initiations, and I wonder if they'll be willing to give that away next game, and we'll see how the draft kind of pans out those first four bans.
Yeah, it'll be interesting whether Spectre even makes it through, to be honest, just on how impactful it's been. But we're gonna quickly take a short break, so I'm sure game 3 will be coming up very shortly. But thanks for tuning in, and don't go anywhere.